HBCU football is on the air, presented by NCAA Football 11. Today's contest features the Jackson State Gamecocks versus Alcorn State Braves. The game starts now.
I'm Brad Nessler, here along with two of the best commentators in the game, Kirk Herbstreit and Lee Corso. No complaints about the weather tonight, as we see nothing but stars in this contest between the Jacksonville State Gamecocks and the Alcorn State Braves. Well, we hope you're as excited as we are for this one. And here come the Braves. We have two good teams here, and I'll be honest with you, I really don't know what to expect from this game.
Jacksonville State has an impressive-looking young man at wideout. Watch for them to go to him early and often in this one. He's the big play man in this offense, so look for him to step up and be the difference.
It's that time. How about it? It's got to be the Braves all the way.
Alcorn State is ready to open this one up as they line up for the opening kick. Kicks off. Manning takes it to 25. He jukes. Now we'll get to see how this quarterback can do today as he comes out onto the field for the first time. Today we got a very good tailback going up against a pretty weak linebacking corps. Do you think the offense will be able to exploit that?
You betcha they will. This running back is as good as they come, and I think they'll give this kid the ball, and he'll make a statement early today.
I'm with you on that one, Scooter. This team does everything possible to get this kid the ball. If he has trouble running the ball, then they'll line him up in the slot and throw it to him. He creates mismatches all over the field, and I don't think this defense is good enough to keep him quiet today.
They line up at the 47. Second and five coming up here. Off. Broke away from one, and down he goes at the 44-yard line. And that one goes for a big, big first down.
You know, every time you run the ball successfully like that, that defense starts to creep up a little bit. That's when you go to the air, my friend. Over the top.
The Gamecocks line up with three wide. Freeman on the run, and he's taken down at the 41-yard line. Freeman gets 3 yards on the carry. It's second down and seven to go. Ball on the 41. Going with the shotgun here. He steps up, surveys the field. Fitzpatrick comes up with a sack. Situation here on third and long. They line up at the 50. Buckle comes to the line with three wide. Buckle drops the throw. He's looking over the middle. The ball is tipped. Incomplete pass. So that'll bring up a fourth down.
The coach spoke really highly of this kid before the game. Now I can see why.
If this guy keeps making plays like that, then there will be a lot more people than his coach talking about him in the future.
Jacksonville State lining up the punt. Horn awaits the snap. Horn punts it, and he didn't kick that ball well at all. Signals for a fair catch. So the offense will come out in opponent's territory for their first drive of the game.
They couldn't have asked for better field position than this.
They have a chance to jump on them here. Let's see if they can do it.
The offense will start at the 26-yard line. Bennett with three wide receivers. Bennett with a nice play fake. Throws it out there. Got it to his receiver. Our cameraman didn't even know who had the ball.
I'm pretty sure the defense didn't either. The halfback did a heck of a job faking like he was running with the ball. They were about to tackle him.
It's first down. The defense is in the nickel. Walker takes it up the middle. Robeson with the tackle at the 49. A 4-yard pickup by the fullback. Second and six. Ball on the 49-yard line. Single set backfield. He steps up. He tosses it short. And it's caught. Harris brings him down at the 48. They completed it, but for a minimal gain.
It's not much, but at least it's positive yards.
Third down. Malone lines up in the deep back, eye formation. Straight ahead with the fullback. And they make the stop at the 44-yard line. So we got enough for the first down there.
Yep, nice call to run the ball there on third down. I like it.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 44. They use four linebackers. Bennett steps back to pass. He looks. Short toss. It's complete. Darlington with the tackle at the 43-yard line. Pickup of less than a yard on the play. We've got second and nine here. Ball on the 43. The Braves set up in the gun. Here's the give. He jukes him. And he's tackled at the 34-yard line. They pick up another first, guys.
Great job here converting and keeping this defense on the field. They're getting very tired.
They line up at the 34. First down. Play action. He throws it. He can't miss. Brought down at the 19-yard line. Flags are down, and this one might be on the offense.
Holding on the offense. 10 yards is on the foul.
It's about time they called him for holding. He's been holding on to jerseys all game.
Scooter, these refs could probably call holding on every play if they wanted to. These guys get away with a lot.
It's first and a mile.
Ball on the 42-yard line.
They use four linebackers. Bennett on first down. He passes it, and it's incomplete.
Now, that one's going to go down in the stats as a drop, but that would have been a tough catch.
Well, when you're going to school for free to play football, they expect you to catch those, Kirk. Now, I know the defender got in there to break it up, but there are just no excuses for that. You touch it, you catch it. That always has been the rule.
Jacksonville State put six DBs on the field to counter this wide receiver look. Walker comes up with a sack. Third down and what they didn't want to get in. And this is the ninth play of the current drive. Bennett is back in the gun. Hasn't missed yet. Under pressure, they'll make the sack. Well, guys, it was the linebacker that got to the quarterback.
Yep, the quarterback should have read that blitz and got rid of the ball.
Alcorn State lining up the punt. Sonny is waiting for the snap. We've played a quarter, and we're all tied up. Fourth and long. They line up to punt this one away. Manning is back deep to return the punt. It's a short kick. And he can't hang on to the ball. Coach, I think he just took his eyes off that.
Oh, yeah. You just can't do things like that.
From the 41-yard line, first down. Three wideouts here. They'll throw on first down. He lets it go. He snags it, and they make the stop at the 30. They pick up solid yardage there.
Yeah, nice little pitch and catch there. The wideout was able to find a little open space in the defense, and the quarterback was able to get him the ball for a good pickup.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 30-yard line. Alcorn State comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. Drops back to pass. He's going left. Complete. Harris with a takedown at the 21-yard line. That one worked pretty well.
Hey, it's a good job here by the wide receiver to get open. He created good separation from the defense.
It's second down.
Ball at the 21-yard line.
Alcorn State sets up in the eye. Bennett with the play fake. He passes it, and it's caught for the touchdown. What a perfectly thrown ball by this young quarterback.
He's gone through a rapid maturation, and that's elevated the level of play for his teammates.
If I was a scout, I'd make sure I'd bring lots of notebook paper to this young man's games.
Here's the try for the extra point. And he converts the extra point. Over 4 minutes remain in the second quarter, and our score is Alcorn State 7, Jacksonville State nothing. Alcorn State is ready to kick it away. Short kick. He didn't get a hold of that one. Manning fields it at the 26. Time once again for this offense to come back out and start another drive. They'll take over at the 44-yard line. Jacksonville State lines up in a shotgun set. Buckle to the air on first down. And he's got him on the fly. And he's tackled. The wideout comes up with a spectacular play.
Yeah, and if I'm the coach, I put a big circle around that play so I can remember to call that one again. Good call.
First down from the gun. Buckle drops back, throws short, and it's caught. Tackle made at the 24-yard line. Well, coach, a short pickup on that pass play.
It was, but you know what? As long as they've got those guys getting open underneath, it'll take a lot of pressure off those offensive linemen who are trying to hold their blocks.
From the 24-yard line, it's second down. Jacksonville State comes to the line with three wide. Buckle, back to pass. Looking, he'll dump this one off. Oh, man, he took him down hard. Nice little catch there, huh, coach?
Yeah, that was a good call. I like that call. I like short passes. They're safe and can lead to some really good yardage.
Third and a couple. They come out with three wide receivers. In setting up play action. He lets it go. So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. They put everyone up on the line. Nice play fake. He's going left. Complete. He made a nice play to keep his foot in bounds there, guys.
I was surprised he was able to come down with that catch.
Yeah, when the ball was thrown, I thought the only person who was going to have a shot at it was one of the onlookers on the sideline. But I really credit this guy for making a fine catch.
First down, 10 yards to go. They're threatening inside the 20. They line up in a double tight set. Buckle has completed every pass this drive. Let's it fly. And that one's incomplete. He had to get rid of that one in a hurry.
The defensive coordinator cooked up a good blitz package that time, and although it didn't result in a sack, it forced a bad throw.
Second down and 10 to go. Jacksonville State comes out with an I formation. Buckle with the give. And they're in. Touchdown. Great call by the offensive coordinator.
Big time play, taking that ball all the way in. Maybe the defense wasn't expecting a run.
We'll be tied with the extra point. And he adds the extra point. So under 3 minutes to go in the second quarter. And the score, Jacksonville State, 7. Alcorn State, 7. Jacksonville State to kick this one off. Davis and Dortch back deep to return. Hits off. Walker takes it to 28. Their last drive ended with a touchdown. Let's see what happens on this possession. First and 10. Bennett comes to the line with three wide. The give. Pierman tackles him at the 42. Malone picks up about 7 yards on the run, so that'll make it second down. They line up at the 42. Second and 3. Two tight end set. Bennett goes with a play fake. Throws short. The big guy with room to run. Bounces off the would-be tackler. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 42-yard line.
You know, it's really easy to overlook those guys on the line.
Yeah, the defense came after them, and those linemen held them long enough for the quarterback to throw for a first down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. Malone is the single setback. Bennett still has it. Throws down the middle. Got him on the run. He's all the way down to the 17-yard line. Alcorn State will take a timeout. That's their first of the half. First down, 10 to go. We'll see what they can do in the red zone. Jensen with a takedown at the 7. Alcorn State will take a timeout. That's their second of the half. They line up at the 7. Second down. The Gamecocks come out in a 34 defense. And now he's going to improvise. Oh, what a hit. And he scrambles for the first down.
He was looking downfield, but nothing was available. So he just tucked it in and got a first down. Nice decision.
First down and goal to go. Ball on the five. The defense has five men up front looking for a big goal line stop here. And it's caught. Touchdown, Alcorn State. He found his fullback for the score.
It's a nice job by the quarterback looking off his primary receivers and dumping it off to the fullback for the touchdown.
So the kicker lines up for the PAT. And he converts the extra point. So with just over a minute to go in the half, the score, Alcorn State 14, Jacksonville State 7. Alcorn State ready to kick this one off. Manning and Thomas back to return. Short kickoff. Thomas takes it to 25. The 50. At the 40. At the 30. To the 20. To the 10. Touchdown, Gamecocks. How about that return?
Great effort there by the returner, reading his blockers and evading the tacklers. And the results, 6 points.
Will be tied with the extra point. And he hits the PAT. So with just over a minute to go in the half, the score, Jacksonville State 14, Alcorn State 14. Jacksonville State lines up for the kickoff. Kicks it away. Davis takes it at the 21. They moved the ball very effectively on their last drive, which ended with a touchdown. The defense has been talking it over on the sideline, trying to make some corrections. Let's see if they can stop them this time. They'll go to work at the 36-yard line. High formation here. First down. He's drilled as he throws. Gray picks it off. Tackle at the 33-yard line. He didn't throw it away under pressure, and it really cost him.
It sure did. He saw that he was going to get hit and just threw one up for grabs. He's got to learn to take the sack.
Go to work at the 33. The offense lines up with three wide receivers. Buckle drops back on first down. Catches it. The 10. He's all the way. Touchdown. They hooked up for the big play.
The coaches do a good job of getting this receiver the ball. They design plays specifically for him, the one we just saw.
And the end results are huge chunks of yardage and touchdowns.
One minute left in the first half.
Yeah.
And he tacks on the extra point. Less than a minute remains in the second quarter, and our score is Jacksonville State 21, Alcorn State 14. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Kicks it off. Dortch takes it at the 21. At the 40. Across midfield. At the 40. At the 30. To the 20. To the 10. They return it all the way for the touchdown. That was a big time return.
Woo! Did you see some of the blocks on that play?
This special teams unit feels like they can score any time.
Can you blame them?
Nope. Not after that return for a touchdown.
And he adds the extra point. Less than a minute remains in the second quarter, and our score is Alcorn State 21, Jacksonville State 21. Alcorn State to kick. Manning and Thomas set to return. And this one's a short kick. Thomas fields it at the 26. But hold on, we got a penalty on the play. Let's check it out.
Good call.
Yeah, he practically brought him to the ground there.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 39-yard line. Going with the shotgun here. Buckle drops back, steps up in the pocket. No one open, so he's going to run. Lee with the tackle at midfield. Jacksonville State just took their first timeout. First down. Jacksonville State lines up with three receivers. Back to pass. He'll dump this one off. And it's caught. And he's tackled at the 40-yard line.
That's a first down right there.
Yeah, if I was a defense, I think I would man up on these guys next time.
Yeah, this quarterback is very good at recognizing zone coverage and then finding the open receiver.
First and 10. Buckles with three wide receivers. Throws it. Got it to him on the run. Lost the ball. Fumble. Lacy digs it off the turf. And it looks like the safety got on that one.
The offense has to hang on to that ball better.
I agree, but you have to give some credit here to the safety. He made a nice play falling on the fumble.
They line up at the 19. First down. Alcorn State goes with the ace set here. Bennett fakes a handoff. Across the middle. He's taken down at the 30-yard line. Nice little pitch and catch with a wideout.
The quarterback and receiver spend a lot of time together. The coaches say they stay after practice just working on their timing, and right there it paid off.
The Gamecocks line up at a 3-4. Incomplete pass. And he misses his wide receiver there.
Yeah, you're right. This is an area that he's worked so hard to improve since day one. The accuracy of his throws, he's improved. But as you can see, he's upset here with himself.
From their own 30-yard line, second down. Alcorn State comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. Bennett drops to throw. Stepping up, lets it go. It's tipped.
Boy, that was a good defensive effort there.
The ball was there, but the defender beat the receiver to it. Nice play.
That'll make it third down. They line up at the 30. Third down and 10 coming up. Bennett drops back, steps up in the pocket, looks, he throws. He ignores the footsteps and makes the catch. A good play to the tight end that time.
Yeah, and this is a play that we saw in practice the other day over and over again.
And as a coach, you like it when all that practice pays off and your players execute in a game like they did all week in practice. Good job.
Got it to him on the run. And down he goes at the 43-yard line. With that pass, they pick up another first down.
And coach, you can feel the momentum building with each first down in this drive.
Yep, this offense is in pretty good rhythm right now.
Alcorn State will take their last time out. First and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. Five wide. Bennett drops back on first down. He's got all day. He's under pressure. Across the middle. Someone got a hand on it. That'll do it for the first half here. We're tied as the players head to the locker room. Jacksonville State got the ball to start the game, so they'll be kicking off to start the second half. And this one's away. Dortch takes it to 25. Across midfield. Good, solid return that time.
You're right. And what allowed him to come up with a nice return were some key blocks up front.
Yep, and a few more of those key blocks, and it would have been really good.
First and 10, ball on the 38. Three-man front defensively. Play action. Down the middle. And this one falls incomplete. He took his eyes off the ball and dropped it.
You got to squeeze that ball, then think about where you're going to go.
It's second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 38-yard line. They're in the eye. Hands it off. He's tackled at the 32. They pick up a good 6 yards there. Third down and 4 coming up on this one. Ball on the 32. Jacksonville State going with a three-man front. Bennett drops back to pass. He's looking for his man. Incomplete. So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Alcorn State goes with the ace set here. He passes it. Dives and caught. How about that pass, fellas?
Well, Brad, the defense was coming with the blitz, and that opened some room for these guys to get open.
Yeah, and if you're coming with the blitz, you better get to this quarterback. Otherwise, he'll make you pay.
First and 10. They're inside the 20. Jacksonville State comes out defensively with 6 defensive backs. Bennett is looking to stay perfect on this drive. Comes across the middle. He's got 3 touchdown passes in this game.
And that last one was the best of the bunch, if you'd ask me. Great throw, great catch.
They're going to flag the celebration there. So they're ready for the extra point. There was some movement on the line.
Dead ball. Ball started on the offense. 5-yard penalty. Repeat the drop.
Now they'll try to tack on the extra point. And he misses the extra point. Craig looks ready to kick this one off. And this one's a short kick. Thomas fields it at the 26. Fumble, loose ball. Thomas picks it up. And they recover their own fumble.
I'm going to tell you something. This guy has got to do a better job of protecting the football the next time he gets it.
They'll start at the 39. Jacksonville State comes out with an I formation. Freeman, the ball carrier. Rooney with a takedown at the 40-yard line. And he gets a yard on the run. It's second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 40-yard line. The defense lines up in a dime. To pass. Throwing left. His receiver has it. That's a great tackle at the 49.
The defense was coming with heat on that play.
Yep, but the offensive line did a good job of picking up their assignments, and that gave the quarterback enough time to throw a nice pass to pick up the first down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball in the 49. Jacksonville State lines up with three receivers. Lets it fly. Catches it. Fumble! Scooped up by the offense. They'll bring him down at the 40. Looks like they got a lucky break there, guys.
What was the receiver doing on that play?
He sure wasn't holding onto the football very well, that's for sure.
First and 10. Ball on the 40-yard line. Jacksonville State comes out in the shotgun. Here's a little draw play. They'll get him for a loss.
Great job by the defensive lineman here to get a paw on him and put him to the turf.
They line up at the 41. Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. The Braves bring in their dime package. He lets it go. And he's got him on the streak. And he's finally shoved out at the 13-yard line. That was a nice play.
You know, we talk about this every week, adjusting to the blitz. The quarterback and the receiver do an excellent job of recognizing the blitz and adjusting to the play. Good-looking pass.
They're in the red zone. The offense got six the last time they were inside the 20. Let's see what they do here. Freeman takes it up the middle. Brown tackles him at the 8. 4, maybe 5 yards on the run. They're at the 8. Second down. Buckle goes with a play fake. Throws, and it's incomplete. What a close call for this defense.
You're absolutely right. You're not going to see him drop the ball like that too often. What a break for the defense.
They line up at the 8. It's third down and 5 to go. Buckle lines up in the shotgun. Defense Lawrence looking for his first incompletion this drive. They'll make the sack.
That's what happens when the protection breaks down up front.
Yeah, but Coach, I think the quarterback has to release the ball quicker or he's going to get pounded out there.
It's fourth down, and the field goal unit is out there to try this 34-yarder. The kick is up, and the field goal is good. Thomas, ready to kick. He sends it downfield. Beverly fields it at the 27. And now we'll see the offense coming out of the field for their next possession. They'll take over at the 41.
First and 10.
They're in the eye. A little misdirection. Tackle made at the 43-yard line. Couple of yards there by the tailback on the counter. Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on their own 43. Alcorn State lines up with a split backfield. Bennett with a nice play fake. Throwing left. And they couldn't hook up on that one. Davis was the intended target. That'll make it third down. From their own 43-yard line, it's third down and 8 to go. From the gun, Bennett with the give. Walker brings him down for a loss. They didn't have the ball long there.
Having ball control is important in football, and three and out is what you want to avoid for sure.
The Braves line up to punt. Sonny awaits the snap. Didn't get all of that one. A scoring drive, the last time out for this offense, and they'll huddle up for this drive. They'll get the ball here at the 47. The Gamecocks line up with four wideouts, throws it out there. The senior makes the catch. The screen play worked that time for a decent pickup.
Yep, you're right. Excellent call to go to the screen to maybe slow down this defensive pass rush a little bit.
A field goal is the difference as we head to the fourth quarter. Second down. From the gun. Buckle with the option. And he's hammered down. Third down. He's looking to pass. He's looking down the middle. They can't connect. Incomplete.
That's going to bring up fourth down, Coach.
That was a tough pass to hang on to, but on third down, I think that's the kick you have to make.
And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. Five DBs on the field. Buckle drops back, steps up, looking, tosses short. He snags it, dives for extra yardage.
You know, it's really easy to overlook those guys on the line.
Yeah, the defense came after them, and those linemen held them long enough for the quarterback to throw for a first down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 40-yard line. From the gun. He throws it. And he's got him again. Lacey with the tackle at the 23. How about that pass, fellas?
Well, Brad, the defense was coming with the blitz, and that opened some room for these guys to get open.
Yeah, and if you're coming with the blitz, you better get to this quarterback. Otherwise, he'll make you pay.
They line up at the 23. It's first down. Alcorn State brings in their nickel package. There's a play fake. Let's it go. And it's caught. Looked like the linebackers bit on that play fake.
I didn't even know the quarterback had the ball. That's worth a yoke.
The kicker got them points on their last red zone visit. Let's see if the offense can get points this time. Buckle with a nice play fake. Fires to the end zone. Touchdown, and that gives them the lead. And that's a second time today these guys have been able to hook up for the score.
Boy, he really looks comfortable in that end zone, doesn't he?
And they're lining up for the PAT. And he converts the extra point. So with less than 4 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter, our score, Jacksonville State 31, Alcorn State 27. Jacksonville State to kick this one off. And this one's a short kick. Dortch fields it at the 24. Not a very good series for this offense on their last drive as they were forced into a three and out.
Boy, oh boy, they had nothing going last time.
Yeah, maybe, Scooter, you need to get out there and show them what you're made of.
Somebody get me a helmet quickly.
This drive will start at the 43-yard line. The Braves line up with a single set backfield. He lets it go. Gets past the tackler. Oh, man. He took him down hard. Couldn't get anything out of that. Second down. The Braves set up in the gun. Tackle at the 40. It's third down and 13 to go. Ball on the 40-yard line. The Gamecocks line up in a nickelback. Under heavy pressure. He's sacked at the 32.
How about the athletic move by that kid? Unbelievable for his size.
Boy, is he an amazing athlete? You know what happened there? The offensive line was so focused on picking up the blitz, they forgot about blocking the defensive line.
They line up to punt this one away. Manning is the deep man awaiting the return. Sonny punched it and he didn't kick that ball well at all. Manning takes it at the 43. To the 20, to the 10. He returns it all the way to score. Oh, that's going to get the old heart pumping.
I'll tell you what, the special teams coach has to be very proud there. That play was designed perfectly and even executed better.
Here's the try for the extra point. And he tacks on the extra point. So with just over 2 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter, our score, Jacksonville State 38, Alcorn State 27. Jacksonville State lines up for the kickoff. Short kick. He didn't get a hold of that one. Dortch takes it at the 20. At the 40. Guys, what are you thinking at this point in the game?
Well, time isn't on their side anymore. They need to get this ball down the field and get in the end zone.
You're right, Coach. It's now a two-possession game. Not too much time to spare.
They'll start at the 46-yard line. Malone, the lone back. Bennett drops to throw. There's a fumble. Defense says they've got it, and they do. What a play. The linebacker comes up with a fumble.
That was a nice play. Couldn't have done better myself, you guys.
Two minutes left in the ball game. Three wideouts here. Freeman gets a handoff to the right. And he's tackled at the 27-yard line. Alcorn State will take their first time out of the half. First down, Buckles with three wide receivers. Freeman, left side, he's tackled at the 25. Alcorn State will take a timeout. That's their second of the half. Second and eight. Ball on the 25-yard line. Buckle will hand it off. Missed tackle. And down he goes at the 19-yard line. The fullback bangs it in there for a gain of six. Trips right. Buckle options out to the right, and now he pitches it. He gets hit out of bounds at the eight. And they were lucky that one didn't go for more.
No question, and they were not ready for that option play. They had guys running everywhere except to the ball.
Lee, you're right. They looked like they've never defended the option before. The tailback had a ton of running room there.
Congratulations to our players of the game. These guys were playing on a very high level today. Three wideouts to the right side. Freeman gets it on the counter. Brings him down for a loss. Alcorn State will use their final timeout. Threatening inside the 10. The Gamecocks line up in a goal line formation. Freeman gets the call again. Brought down at the 4. The halfback gets the call and picks up 5. Here we go, folks. It's third and goal, and the offense needs about 4 yards to get in the end zone. Jacksonville State lines up in a shotgun set. get it again. And they make the stop at the 2-yard line. The running back gets two on the carry. Fourth down, and this one's a chip shot about 19 yards away. And that's pretty much going to do it. What are your final thoughts on this game, Kirk?
It was a good game, but I'm sure there's a little disappointment down there. Alcorn State had a few missed opportunities in this game. I think if they could have capitalized on a few of them, it would have been a lot closer, and they might even have won this game.
Folks, thanks for tuning into our game. Our final score, Jacksonville State 38, Alcorn State 27. I'm Brad Nessler, along with Lee Corso and Kirk Herbstreit. I'd like to thank you for playing, and we'll see you next time.